Oddities, Curiosities Expo in Anaheim, California.
Thank you for visiting my channel. This is Sandra from Recently Retired and Living My Best Life. Please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel so you can follow along to all the places I'm going to see and experience this year in 2023. Drop me a comment below so I know what you liked about the video and what you want to see more of. I hope you enjoyed the video from the Anaheim Convention Center at the Anaheim Oddities and Curiosities Expo. Now, let's do this together, okay? The Oddities and Curiosities Expo was a one-day event held on January 7th at the Anaheim Convention Center. It showcases hand-selected vendors, dealers, artists, and small businesses with all things weird. You'll find items such as taxidermy, preserved specimen, original artwork, horror and Halloween-inspired pieces, antiques, handcrafted oddities, quack medical devices, creepy clothing, odd jewelry, skulls and bones, funeral collectibles, and much, much more. They truly have something weird for everyone at their shows. All items you see at the shows are legal to own and sustainably sourced. Outside of their curated vendors, they host sideshow performers on stage all throughout the day and the opportunity to learn the craft of taxidermy with classes available during the expo. The expo provides a safe place for anyone to come and discover new artists, meet new friends, and be surrounded by an amazing community of like-minded people. They pride themselves in being a completely DIY ran show from start to finish. They find a lot of joy in being able to provide a place where you can feel at home, surrounded by others that share the same interests. They are the first and original traveling event exclusively showcasing oddities, vendors, and dark artists in the country. They are a one-of-a-kind event and the first to do what they specialize in. They take tremendous pride and hope to gain the support of many along the way. Imagine, will you, at the end of the day at the carnival, you've had your fill of laughter, lights, and cotton candy. You wander to the quiet outskirts looking for a place to be alone. And you leave the lights and enter the shadows. You encounter the remnants of a sideshow tent from years gone by. Weathered wood boxes cling to the perimeter of the tent. The ratty old entrance flap hangs, torn in the ghostly breeze. Skepticism takes a back seat to curiosity, and you take a step inside. Inside is dimly lit by lanterns and candles. Your eyes slowly begin to adjust, and you cautiously look around. You discover the castaway remains of a clown and his unique collection. It seems that because of his unsavory interests, the clown was ostracized by the very carnival that he loved. He was sentenced to a life of solitude, alone with his only his hoard of cryptic creations. He burned in his own personal hell, a prisoner of his own making. His was a life of horror that gladly welcomed death. May peace come to this mad clown. Bear witness to bizarre pieces of agony, magical powers, folklore, and preserved death. Behold a collection of taxidermied pets, the remains of carnival animals and patrons, and the remnants of a happy place now turned gray. Encounter terrifying beasts like the real mermaid, a 6-foot man-eating chicken, and genetically engineered monsters. Be mesmerized by the old-school freak show and experience the terror of a mad clown's cryptic collection. Now, I stepped inside this mad place for you, and you get to see what I saw through my eyes. There were some weird and creepy things, some things that made me a little uncomfortable, but I still enjoyed the day. So hopefully you'll enjoy it with me and let me know what you think, okay? I'll leave you now for the rest of the video to enjoy.
Yeah, I kind of like this one too.
And now on to the Mad Clown Museum to see some freaky taxidermied animals and other sideshow freaks.
Man-eating chicken, 6 foot man-eating chicken. Science gone wrong. Here I go, the Mad Clown Museum. Is that it? I guess we're going into some farm animals. What happened to him? His legs are up. He's got some extra legs up there. Two-headed calf, a two-headed goat. Got some more two-headed animals, another calf, goose. Ooh. Hypnotizing or mesmerizing. I am a little dizzy. Especially this one that's right next to me. Boy, way. Rest in peace. What happened to her? Got some body parts down here. Ooh, got some gold teeth. Oh, and another missing head. And some feet. Oh. Alien. Oh, is this the Fiji mermaid? warning, man-eating chicken, ugly beast, turn back now. 6 foot man-eating chicken. Huh. How's the chicken?
Looks delicious. My
favorite. Just prepared? Have a good day. And of course, you leave a museum and you go right to the gift shop, or in this case, the gift booth. Graveyard Mafia. Here's another one. Looks a little newer. Okay. Aren't you supposed to be in the back? Oy wey. Graveyard Mafia is a hearse club? For real?
Yeah.
Interesting. It's a little creepy. Turn a taxidermy into art?
I think I want to cut that. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Like I want to look.
I want to buy these earrings.
There's
I want
another one.
Go ahead.
I'm not sure what I think. I'm a little creeped out.
I'm going to look at that one art that I know I like, and then if I don't find anything I want to come back to it. Is that fair? And if
another one. I'm a little creeped out. I'm not sure what I think. I don't think I like it. These are a little scary. Spencil and spray paint. Nice. You did these?
Yes, it's all my original art.
Oh my gosh, they're beautiful. I don't know if I would use beautiful, but you know what I mean. Very talented.
Thank you. It's all stencil and spray paint, so everything is a hand cut stencil.
Yeah? Oh yeah, David Bowie even. Yeah. Wow. There's David Bowie.
More than one,
everything's my original
artwork.
Wow.
Yes. I got you right here.
The witches and devils.
And then, throw in any sticker that you'd like from there, you can throw in. Let me see.
I like your look too.
Thank you so much. I did make it, yeah. What was your preferred payment method?
A card.
Okay, gotcha.
That was pretty.
Oh, that's nice to hang.
They're over there.
These are beautiful. Tentacles makes this adorable bunny rabbit.
Do you want the dragon?
Share your three-eyed cat photos. Interesting.
Wait, look at this one.
Aww.
Do you like the whole one? Do you like the whole one?
I like the middle of the whole body.
Where the original
snake? There's some.
That one.
Mad Tatters. Some interesting art in here. Two-dimensional. Oh, it's kind of cool. $250.
That's this.
Different.
Oh, I like the t-shirts. There's an eye.
Deadly menu of the deadly sweet. Those are cute shirts. Oh my. Very sweet.
No, they don't. No, and they'll last 2-3 days. Thank you.
Blood bath. These are soaps, wax melts, pomade. Soap dome, shampoos, and body spray. Here's another purse. This one's Reaper. Ghostbusters here. That's pretty cool. Ursula. Sanderson sisters are on here. This is cool. Here's another one. The Shining. Casper. Beetlejuice. Even some Disney stuff. Oh, yeah, Patrick Swayze. Hitchhiking Ghosts. And here's a Twilight Zone.
Your
10. Reunion of Vampires. Jordan Monsell. There's the artist. Who remembers Goosebumps? Look at all these. Vintage movies.
Yeah, we just try to have weird stuff all the time.
Prints like made out of a messed up cassette tape.
Yeah.
Look at this thing made here. Jewelry box. Junk into treasure. Some creative people here. Fester's Monsters. What does he have to sell? Frankenstein. The Creature. And Elvira's over here. Get a zombie mask for $1,400. That one for $300. Vintage antiques, dead people stuff for sale. And that's who's doing it. Ocean Beach Antique Mall in San Diego. $1,934. $0.35.
Yeah.
monkeys on a bread. But we're not getting
that. Now on to a couple of side freak shows. This first one here was a little creepy with a nail up her nose and she ate some glass, snapped her tongue with a mouse trap. She must have a very high pain tolerance, whether it was real or not.
Because I don't trust guys to pull out. You're young, you'll understand what that means when you're older. Okay, we're gonna come right up here so everyone can see. Where is your family? You're so calm. Why are you so cool about this? Are you a weirdo or something? I am. All right, so we're gonna pinch the end of this and then I'm gonna do the rest, okay? Don't yank it out of me. Don't shove it into me. I promise, shaking. Are you okay? All right, hold on, wait, grab it. Hang on, you gotta hang on tight. Hang on, no, hang on. Ew, wait, it's itching. Hold on to it, you gotta grab it. Don't make this weird, why are you making this gross? Ew, yuck, ew, yuck.
Do you have any dentists here? Did I ask that? You're a dentist? I'm going to apologize before I do this part. Do you want a Ziploc baggie from the Dollar Tree? All right. Now what we're going to do is gently place this on the floor. And we're going to take this and we're going to just give that thing one good whack and crack the light bulb. Sharp piece of glass. Oh my gosh. Is Mike still back there? Honey Bunny, can you bring me a delicious liquid death canned beverage? I forgot mine. I need a chaser for this. Thank you so much. You're so sweet. Have you ever tried a liquid death water? It's delicious. It's mountain water from the Alps. Go. Oh yeah. Oh, we're doing it.
Ew.
I apologize ahead of time. You alright? We're doing good. She's going, what is this clown doing? Clown stuff. Please don't do this at home. And also, do not chew with your mouth open. That's disgusting.
Ew.
Let's put it this way, if you found out it was, I wouldn't be taken aback.
Will you look at my mouth and tell me, am I bleeding to death? Are there many shards of glass still attached to my tongue? There's a lot in there, hang on. Anybody want to make out? This could be somebody's new adventure in their life. There's still glass on my tongue.
The second show was a sword swallower. He was extremely talented. I tried to get close up and zoom in as much as I could to catch any trickery or anything like that, but didn't see anything other than the swords disappearing down his throat. He also must have a high pain tolerance and no gag reflex, but I was doing the gagging for him because that was a little too much for me. But enjoy. See if you can catch any tricks he might have done. And let me know in the comments below.
I'll say it again. Double spin. Under the leg and behind the back. In rapid order. And then if I get the timing right, I will eat off the candy and not go for any of the blank knives. Yes, this has gone wrong before. Yes, I have the scars to prove it. Now watch closely, boy.
Yikes.
Boys, hush, fall over a crowd like that. Wow. That's good. I know you're focusing. You're focusing. So am I. Double spin. We got the under the leg. Got a hook. I'm sorry I ruined your TikTok. Now, one more thing, folks. For anybody who is actually legitimately afraid for my health on this part, it's okay. I'm a trained professional. I will be okay. All right, nevertheless, here we go, folks. First official story of the show. Down the hatch, without a scratch.
Oh. Yikes.
There we go. Three solid steel blades at the same time. Now that's happened before. Like I've been able to do that for a good few years now, and then like quite some time ago, I figured, you know what? Why don't we up the ante a little bit? Ladies and gentlemen, I then was able to swallow four swords at the same time. That was just a couple years ago. And then I just realized, like, oh, I'm gonna do four? Why not try five swords at the same time? Yes, indeed, folks, five swords. But then just recently, after so much thought, so much consideration, and hard work, and again, hard thought, I drew the line at five. Drew the line at five for a very simple reason. On my way from going from four to five, I realized this. The pause is no different. Even though the danger is substantially greater here, it's like, for the more swords that you add, the more the danger is of them scissoring, slicing me up from the inside out, puncturing any of my organs, making me die right before your very eyes, and looking at some of your faces, you're like, yeah, die, sword swallower, die. I'm contracted for more shows, folks. I kind of gotta... Nevertheless, here we go. For your demented entertainment, five swords at the same time. Rug and the Mystic, get well soon. Here we go. It just goes straight up my ass. Complete solid steel. Now I'm going to swallow this one all the way down so close that I can close my lips around the end of it. And then for those of you watching closely, I'm then going to take a bow and open my mouth, showing you the blade literally going down my throat. I do apologize to any of you who have recently eaten. But it still brings me so much joy. Your reactions are cool. One blade, no handle, down the hatch. Hopefully, I don't lose it again.
Again. Oh. Oh. Oh, wow.
Oh. There you go. Mention it, Kyle. Low front row. Now, obviously this doesn't last long. So if you just happen to find this impressive, please clap quickly. Actually, in fact, let's go ahead and start off with the rhythmic clap. 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 Good. Keep it up. Showstopper. Onward. And awkward.
Uh.
make sure you kept eye contact the whole time during that one. You're both real bad. Here
we go. Yikes.
If you care about my health, and the health of the front row, if you really want to see the knife throwing, as soon as my hands come off this blade, please give it your all. Make it as light as you can. So if this would be the last stunt I ever perform, at least I know it was worth it. As my plastic surgeon always said, you gotta go, go with a smile. All right, no more fooling around. Here we go, folks. The ultimate sword swallowing stunt, also known as the $100 stunt.
Oh, yikes. Oh! Wow.
His assistant, who happens to be his wife, must have nerves of steel, because I didn't catch her reacting or flinching at all. 100% complete trust in her husband.
Okay, that's gonna do it for the Oddities and Curiosities Expo in Anaheim, California. Hope you liked the video. Make sure you hit the like button and subscribe to my channel so you can see what I have going on for the year 2023. This is Sandra from Recently Retired and Living My Best Life. Be nice to each other, everybody, and I'll see you in the next video.